From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. A brother and sister convicted in a murder plot to kill Winston George were sentenced in York County Superior Court today. Darlene George was sentenced to 40 years in prison in connection with the death of her husband, Winston George. Prosecutors say Darlene George enlisted the help of her brother, Jeffrey Williams, and another man to kill her husband and to make it look like a home invasion. The victim was tied up, beaten, and suffocated with a liquor bottle in his home back in June of 2008. A jury convicted Darlene George and Jeffrey Williams during a two-week trial in June. Williams was sentenced today as well to life in prison. Family and friends of the victim were in court when the sentences were handed down.
So he was murdered one day before his 45th birthday. So let's just say, theoretically, she robbed him of at least 45 years of his life. She should do that much.
What we was looking for, because he's the guy that put his hands on my brother. That is excellent.
Irene Cassamy, the third person involved in this case, pleaded guilty and testified against the other two. He is serving an 8-year sentence for conspiracy to commit murder. A mental health agency in Auburn will close by the end of the month. That word comes just a couple of weeks after the state cited the facilities for deficiencies. A spokesman for the Maine Department of Health and Human Services says Possibilities Counseling submitted their 30-day notice late Friday. Possibilities serves thousands of clients around Maine, but the state says 16 of the 18 people who worked there all quit on the same day, and then the company tried to fill the jobs with family and friends who were not properly trained. We tried to contact someone from Possibilities Counseling for their comment today about the closing, but our calls were not returned. A very special day in Portland today. Hundreds of people came out for the annual Cure Breast Cancer for Me luncheon. It took place this afternoon at the Holiday Inn by the Bay and was once again sponsored in part by News 8. The luncheon honors breast cancer survivors as well as those who have lost their battle with the disease. Money raised from today's luncheon goes to support the Maine Cancer Foundation's Women's Cancer Research Fund, and all the money stays right here in Maine. The second annual Dempsey Challenge is in the books, and by all of accounts, it was a huge success. Organizers say nearly 4,200 people took part, helping to raise more than $1.1 million, and they are still counting. Every penny of that money goes right to the Patrick Dempsey Center for Cancer Hope and Healing, located at Central Maine Medical Center. News 8 is a proud sponsor of the Dempsey Challenge, and we have much more about the event on our website, WMTW.com, including one-on-one interviews with Patrick Dempsey himself. That is never too early to start planning for next year's Dempsey Challenge. It's scheduled for October 8th and 9th. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.